Hi everyone, welcome to the step-by-step tutorial on Rabby Wallet. This is a very powerful wallet for Ethereum and other EVM compatible chains such as Optimism, Base, Binance Chain, and many, many more. It's secure, it's easy to use, it has additional features that are not available in other wallets, so that's why we're recommending it. This guide will help you how to get started, downloading it, setting it up, how to send, receive, and swap crypto. So let's dive in. First things first, let's download the wallet. Make sure you're on rabby.io, and then we're going to start with downloading the extension. They also have a mobile wallet, but start with the extension as it's a little bit easier to interact with dApps and just see what you're doing when you're starting off in crypto. So start with downloading the Chrome extension and then just go ahead and add to Chrome. Okay. Since this is your first time, you're going to go ahead and create a new address. Make sure you understand this next step. This is where we're going to create your seed phrase. So grab your notebook or your diary and write down your 12 words. Make sure you're not taking a screenshot or writing it on your phone. The best and most secure way is storing your seed phrase offline. All right, you got your book? Great. Let's go ahead and show the seed phrase. Make sure you're writing it down in the exact same order and double check the spelling. If you get it wrong here, you might get in trouble later. So please take your time and just double check so you got everything right. Okay, you've saved it. Great. Let's go ahead. Here, you're going to create a password. This is just locally, so you don't have to put in your seed phrase every time you're logging into your wallet. Okay, go ahead and confirm. Success, you got your seed phrase. Now click on your extensions and pin the wallet. This is going to make it easier for when you're logging into apps to get easy access to your wallet. Congratulations, you got your first wallet. Of course, you don't have any ETH in your wallet, so we're going to start with sending yourself some ETH from your exchange from Kraken to this wallet. So you do so by going to receive, and this is where you're going to copy your receiving address. So click on it first. The default chain is Ethereum. Since most of the apps that we interact with are on Optimism, go ahead and choose Optimism. Short is just OP. You can also pin it here. Click. And this is your receiving address, your public address, and this address you can share with anyone, your friends that want to send you some crypto. So you can pause this video here, copy the address, and this is the address you copy and paste into Kraken and send yourself some ETH. Now it's actually the same address on all the EVM compatible chains, but just for best practices, I would always choose the chain you want to receive to. One neat thing you can do is name your address something. This is going to make sense if you start adding more addresses. It's just going to make things more clear. Click on the address. Under note, a little pen, and name it. I'm just going to name it test. One wallet. Confirm. Okay, you got the test one wallet here. Okay, great. You managed to send yourself some ETH. This is the value of your portfolio. And if you want to see more details, you just click on this arrow here. You can see, okay, you got ETH. It's indeed on the Optimism chain and the value is $17. Whoop, whoop. So if you start adding more chains and more tokens, you're going to see an indication here of ZK Sync, Ethereum, so on. And all of the tokens are going to be displayed here with their chains. Let's continue with sending out some crypto. So you can send yourself some crypto to your exchange, copy your address there, and come back here. So locate the send button, of course, click. This is where you choose the network. We're going to stay on Optimism. And copy and paste your Kraken address here. And then you choose how much you want to send out, of course. We're just going to send out a few dollars or $1. You know, this address isn't whitelisted since this is the first time you're transferring from. So go ahead and put in your password. Okay, now double check that you are sending the correct amount to the correct address. And if it's all okay, you can go ahead and send. Now, there's another step here where you can double check that everything is correct. Now, there is a warning sign. So go ahead and click and check what it is. All right, it's just saying that this is the first time you're transferring to this address. But if it would be any kind of problem, some phishing site, you would get a warning here. And this is special for Rabby Wallet. And that's why we recommend using it. Okay, you can go ahead and ignore that. Everything's fine. Next up, you can also change your gas fee. Do it here. Instant, of course, it's a bit faster. Normal is a little bit cheaper and slower. I usually go with fast, so we're happy with fast. Now there's going to be a double click here. So first you sign, go ahead and sign, and then you confirm. So the confirm is when you're actually submitting it to the blockchain. Okay, there you go, your first transaction. Now I just want to mention, if something doesn't work, it might mean that you have to update your wallet. Rabby Wallet does frequent updates, so just go ahead and update it. I would do it almost like once a week or once every 2 weeks. They have some new updates, so make sure you keep updating it. Next up, let's do a swap. So locate the swap button, click on it, and we're going to exchange ETH for another token. Let's keep it simple and choose USDC or USDT. I'm going with USDC. And just, you know, choose less than a dollar or around a dollar. All right, it found an exchange and go ahead and click on the swap button. Okay, great. You're going to pay your gas fee here, sign, and then confirm. All right, great. The transaction is done and you can double check by clicking on the arrow, right? You have your USDC, you have your ETH. It's right there. When you're doing a swap, don't forget to keep a little bit of ETH in your wallet because you need the ETH to pay for your gas fee. So no ETH, no swap. Now, of course, later on when you have NFTs, you can find them here. This is also all of your transactions. Just click on it and it will show you that you've sent, you've received, you did a swap. In my case, Rabby Wallet chose Kyber Swaps. Might have chose another dApp in your case. But that's the convenient thing with Rabby Wallet. It does it for you, so you don't have to go and manually swap on a dApp, but you can do it directly in your wallet, and not all wallets offer this. So that's another good thing. Okay, the last thing I want to show you today is how to bridge over to another network. Go ahead and find the bridge button. So this means you're actually sending yourself money just on a different chain. Perhaps you want to send yourself some ETH on Ethereum main chain because you want to buy an NFT there, or you want to interact with a specific app that's just on Arbitrum or Base. So you can go ahead and click on Base. This is a really popular layer 2 that is made by Coinbase. Now, I suggest when you bridge over to just do it with ETH. As you can see, it has the most liquidity, so go ahead and choose that. So click on ETH, and you can choose just a dollar or two. All right, you chose your amount, and this is the dApp that Rabby Wallet chose. If you're okay with that, you can go ahead and bridge. All right, fast, instant, normal, choose whichever you're comfortable with, and then you're going to sign and confirm. Bridging might take a few moments, but don't worry, it's there. You can check your transactions. Okay, you can see Bungie, it happened. And now there's a little indication here that popped up. You click on the arrow. All right, it's been added here. This is the Base logo and Optimism. All right, thank you everyone. That's it for today. If you want to, you can check out more over here. Some extra settings, of course. But that's it for today. You did well. See you in the next module.